Hello friends, welcome to our channel. As I told you, in this video we are going to look about the excess pressure inside a spherical soap bubble. In the last video we have talked about the same similar concept but for a spherical drop. So there only I told you the difference. The spherical drop is a solid thing. Yes, there will be only one surface in contact with the air. But now in the spherical soap bubble, or simply we can call the bubble, we have two surfaces of that bubble which are in contact with air, right? So this is what we can say, the outer surface, which is again in contact with the air, and this inner surface also. The inner surface, we know whenever we are talking about a bubble, we have air in the bubble also. When bubble we can say breaks, we know the air comes out that. And yes, obviously the pressure inside that particular bubble is more, high pressure air is there. Okay, so therefore we have two surfaces in this particular spherical bubble as compared to our droplet. Okay, so again similarly we will consider a spherical bubble, so bubble of radius r and with center O. So whenever we want to find that, again we should go in the similar manner. So since this soap bubble is having two surfaces, therefore whatever may be the force which is due to the surface tension, that force is twice than that of the droplet, as we have seen in case of droplet. So for finding that, we simply use the basic definition of force. Force is nothing but, or basic definition of pressure. Pressure is nothing but force per unit area, and from that we got this one. Force is equal to, moreover here it is due to the surface tension. First of all we will find due to the surface tension, and this, yes obviously this there in the previous video we have earlier find this and then that, so no worries. So this is due to what we can say, the excess pressure. So here simply we can find using this, force is equal to pressure into area. That will be the next equation. Here we have taken this for first. Okay, no worries. So here, but due to surface tension, force due to surface tension, it is obviously, since we have two surfaces which are in contact with the air, therefore the force will be twice times the surface tension into length. Since again here we are using the basic definition of surface tension, T is equal to, what is surface tension? Force per unit length. So this gives force is equal to surface tension into length, but we have two surfaces, that's why we have multiplied with these two, 2 into surface tension into length. So 2 surface tension T and 2 pi r, obviously 2 pi r is what? The circumference of this hemisphere. If I consider a section of this again, and obviously which is of a radius r, so, and it is a circle. So therefore what happens? Therefore this it's a circle, and whose circumference is 2 pi into r. So 2t into 2 pi r. So let us keep as it is for a while, since we want to use this equation again further. So there we will cancel the things. So Pf is equal to 2 into 2 pi rt. This is what? The force due to the surface tension, right? And we know that there is a counterbalancing force which is due to the pressure, excess pressure which is inside the bubble. And that force is simply, force is nothing but pressure into area, right? So the pressure is P, and area of this particular hemispherical or that sectional cross section, it is in circular nature, so its area will be pi r square. So force is equal to P into pi r square. Now we know these two forces which are in equation 1 and 2 are balancing each other, therefore this particular bubble can maintain its spherical nature, we can say, or we can say to maintain the equilibrium condition, to maintain the equilibrium of the bubble, these two forces must be counterbalanced to each other, and therefore we should equate them. So equating 1 and 2, we will get P is equal to, sorry, this force and this force, left hand side same, right hand side must be same, and that is what, P pi r square, it is equation 1 is equal to equation, sorry, it is 2, 1, it is 2, it is 1, so 2 into 2 pi rt, which one we can find first, right? Whether you can do this later and this again, no matters. So here let us cancel the pi pi, and see, take this r square to that side, it will go in the denominator. So 1r again will get cancelled, and finally what we get is a simple equation, which is p is equal to 2 times of 2t divided by r. If you remember, this bracket is nothing but the excess pressure inside a spherical drop, right, that we have seen in last video. So I will post the link of that video all in the description box of this, so that you will have the correlation between those two videos, right? So this is what, 2 times the pressure inside a drop, right? So this complete equation, equation 3, gives the excess pressure inside the spherical bubble. But if we have want the relation between excess pressure inside the bubble and inside the drop, so we can write this is for bubble. So excess pressure inside a bubble, obviously spherical, is equal to twice of excess pressure, because what is this? This bracket is nothing but excess pressure inside a spherical drop. Excess pressure inside drop. Okay, so always the pressure which is or the excess pressure in a bubble is always double than that of the excess pressure of that particular droplet of the same size, if we want, we can say, because radius is same. Yes, so this is about simple phenomena, the excess of pressure inside a spherical drop and spherical bubble. The spherical drop we have seen in the last video. The link of that video I will post in this box, description box of this video. So have the look on both the videos, and if you have any doubt, then you can post in the comment box. Otherwise, if you feel this is a value addition to your knowledge, then like this video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for getting notifications of our future videos, right? So thank you friends for watching this video. We'll meet in the next video very soon with new concept. Till then, keep watching, keep learning, and take care. Thank you.